We have with us Israel Mekov, chairman of Sun Pharmaceuticals, to speak about Sun as well as a lot that's happening in the pharma industry. Mr. Mekov, thanks a lot for speaking with CNBC TV 18. Let me begin by asking you the most concurrent subject, which is the Sun-Rand vaccine merger. You're pretty close to closing the deal with the CCI's conditional nod that has come in, but there is a rider that you have to divest seven of the products from the combined entity's portfolio. 6 months is the timeline. How close are you in that process? Because I'm sure you would have already started assessing the buyers and the bids. How close are you and how confident are you of getting good valuations?
Well, first of all, I have to tell you that we have started the day after the CCI order. This is number one. Secondly, look, we are divesting good assets. We are not divesting bad assets. We are divesting good assets. Mm-hmm. And you have a lot of buyers for good assets. Mm-hmm. And we will have no problem of this divestment. Mm-hmm. And we will do it as fast as we can. Mm-hmm. But it will be fast.
Right. In terms of seeking valuations, your market assessment, what does it throw up in terms of the kind of valuations that you could get for these products? Total, I think it is less than 50 crores, the combined seven products.
I have to tell you something. You want me now to negotiate over the TV the price or what?
No, but generally in terms of...
We'll try to get the best valuation for that, the best value. This is what we are going to do.
Mm-hmm. All right. In terms of the other big stuff that is waiting to be unleashed, is the FTC and their list of products that they could ask you to divest from the U.S. market. What sort of dialogue are you having with the FTC?
I'm not going to comment on the dialogue. We have a good dialogue with them.
Any timelines?
I don't have a timelines, but we are on the way to close it. We have to, you know, I can assure you that when we finish all the roads, we still have a roadmap here, you know, because we still have the High Court of Punjab to approve it. Hmm. Once this is done, we are closing.
All right. So with the CCI's nod already in place, FTC dialogues progressing, what sort of a timeline have you set for yourself or the two companies to close this deal?
Look, we have set a time at the beginning, which will be, you know, by the end of this year. But
right.
The delays are not delays by us. Mm. It's not that we are unable to close. We were ready to close 6 months ago, you know. Mm. That's the issue. Mm. But we are waiting just for the approvals. Mm. And I hope that within the next few weeks, the next very few months, we will get it. That's all.
All right. So once the approvals are done, obviously the process of integration will only begin from that point on.
But it's well planned. This is the point. You know,
yeah.
It's not that we are going to start planning, take a year to plan, etc. We are waiting for the green light in order to move ahead with the integration. It's all planned by details in every form.
Right. Fair enough. Next question was exactly that. What sort of planning have you done for the integration? If you could run us through some of the basics, which would be the first steps that you would take
approvals. I'm not going to announce it publicly. I can tell you that we have run a very thorough integration plan.
Mm-hmm.
The integration plan was done by us, was done in collaboration with people of Ranbaxy, management of Ranbaxy, and therefore, you know, it's a collaboration which started on this aspect of planning some time ago.
Right. Sir, you know, when Ranbaxy comes in and the Sun Pharma Ranbaxy combined as an entity would have a larger share, especially in the dermatology space. That would be one therapy area of focus. How do you see that, you know, how do you see the combined entity take the global platform when we talk about the dermatology?
Well, I think that we have already a strong presence in dermatology in the U.S.,
hmm.
very strong presence in dermatology in the U.S.
Hmm.
And you know what's happened when you have a leadership position in a certain area, you are always looking for additional opportunities, and you always get the opportunities because, you know, people would like to work with the leaders, not with the tail.
Hmm, correct. Sir, and also, you know, two of the best minds in the generic pharma space, Mr. Sangvi and Mr. Mekov,
Sangvi is a great mind.
Two of the best minds in the M&A space coming together in Sun Pharma. What sort of plans you have for Sun Pharma from here on you've helped them get onto the big platform, becoming number fifth in the generic space on the international platform. How are you charting the progress from here?
Look, the only thing which I want to tell you, you know, that we will continue to try, we will aim to continue to try to grow at a fast rate, you know, as we did in the past. Mm-hmm. M&A is a tool. M&A is not an objective. M&A is a tool, you know. And if we find first of all, we have to merge on Maxi, and afterwards, you know, if you find an interesting opportunity which will fit our strategy, will fit our objectives, will fit with our DNA company, we'll do that.
How about investing in startups, sir? Because that is what you've also been doing, and Mr. Sangvi, in his personal capacity, has also been looking at investing. How big is an opportunity of investing in startups, how can it turn around?
We are looking into this opportunity. We are making investment in some research, you know, which is done either startups through venture capital, you know. So we are looking into this possibility, and we probably will make a few investments.
And that venture capital fund is as part of the Sun Pharma.
No. We are not creating a venture fund, but we are working with venture fund.
We are working with
venture fund to see opportunities. You know, they screen for us opportunities.
All right. So coming back to Ranbaxy, you know, as chairman of Sun Pharmaceuticals, who's undergoing the merger process of this large stature, how much does the Ranbaxy's issue weigh on your mind as the chairman? Because it does come with a lot of baggage. There are additional issues that are cropping up, like the German ban that has come on the company's plant. How much does that weigh on your mind?
Look, I have to tell you that Sun Pharma is in my mind 24 hours a day. And Ranbaxy is part of Sun Pharma, so there's nothing special to me.
But you're not, you're confident that those issues are resolved?
I'm very confident that we do it, you know. I'm very, very confident that we'll do it right, and we'll come out.
And what's the kind of timeline that you've set aside for turning around Ranbaxy?
This is, you know, we announced that, you know, we are going to get so much synergies with so much time, etc., etc. We're not going to expand on that, you know.
Okay. Sir, you know, talking about the global M&A space in the pharmaceutical side, we've seen a lot happen. There have been big merger talks of Pfizer, AstraZeneca, then a lot happening on the Valium side, big ones and even smaller ones that we've seen happen. How do you see the M&A, M&A positions change the pharmaceutical landscape globally, if we talk about, and where do you see it headed? What's the kind of trend that you're spotting?
Look, first of all, I must tell you that acquisition has become more and more expensive in recent years. You know, they are buying it at very high prices. And I tell you that some of the companies that are buying, you know, continuously, will run into a management problem, because, you know, the complexity of managing a company after acquisition is growing, you know. And if you are a serial acquirer, and every year you acquire one company, or maybe more than one company, and some of these companies are very large, you have to build up the management capacity in order to manage it. And if you are not doing it, you're going to a glass ceiling.
Sir, do you think there is scope for big acquisitions like the one that Pfizer was talking about for AstraZeneca, and they're now approaching another company, we understand Mylan possibly, for a large acquisition that could have run into billions of dollars, multi-billions of dollars?
No, there are many acquisitions of multi-billions of dollars. You know, it's not...
That was taking it to some other level altogether, talking of $100 billion acquisition.
$100 billion acquisition.
Do you think there is scope for such large acquisition?
What do you mean?
To
do
be
you
absorbed,
need escape?
To be absorbed in global.
Pfizer believe that they can do it with AstraZeneca, you know, but they have to, as I say, they have to really build up a huge management capacity in order to make it successful.
Mm-hmm. So the move of multinational drug makers, especially the innovator ones, on the emerging market side, especially for branded generics, what sort of M&A trend do you spot there?
What sort of
M&A trend do you spot there?
I don't really know. We haven't seen much. We haven't seen much of M&A in this area.
Do you think that would be the next step? Because that's how they can.
I'm not so sure. I think that more they will try to collaborate first and then merge. You know, because it's very difficult to, you know, suppose if you buy a company in India, okay, what do you do with it? Mm-hmm. If you are totally a stranger.
Right. And talking about the global pharma space, how well positioned is Sun Pharma to take the next step in terms of acquisition or in terms of at least spotting some of the trends where they can fit in?
I have to tell you that Sun Pharma is well positioned to continue to grow and to continue to deliver value to its shareholders. Mm-hmm. And as I told you, M&A is a tool. And we will use this tool whenever appropriate.
Okay, so just as a last question, okay. Before I let you go.
Okay,
I told you the best is for the last.
The best
so.
Is the last, okay.
So just as a last question, after you took charge as chairman of Sun Pharma, what have been the big few changes that you've brought on to the board or to the company you think...
I'm not going to talk about it. This I'm not going
no,
to
talk I'm talking about in general of the company, no, not in particular about strategies, but... What has been your one mantra that you've given?
I'm sharing my experience and my knowledge with the management of Sun Pharma.
All right, Mr. Mekok, thanks a lot for your time. Thank you.